Okay. Now next concept is go to. What is the next concept? Go to. Go to is a keyword. Go to is what? Keyword. There is no space between go and to. Okay. Listen. Go to takes the control from one place to another place unconditionally. Go to takes the control from one position to another position unconditionally. Okay. Let us take one small example so that you'll understand. Void main. Easy example, this is printf person A, printf B. Let us write here go to last, printf C, printf D, and I'll write last, printf E, printf F. Well, now we'll understand. Go to takes the control from one place to another place unconditionally. Very important point that is. First, what is printed? A is printed. Next, what is printed? B is printed. Go to last. Go to last. Last means true or false. Last is not true or false. Go. That's what I'm telling, right? Go to takes the control from one place to another place unconditionally. Go to last. Your compiler is looking for the last label. Last label. Where is last label? From here, compiler will take to move here. And we are going to print what? E and F. Last is one label, understand. Here, label is ended with what? Colon. Go to is ended with what? Semicolon. So, what is the answer? A, B, E, F. This code is not executed. Okay. Let me explain another example. Easy example is here. Void main. I'll take int A is equal to 1. Printf A, let us take start, printf B, if A less than or equal to 3, printf C, I'll make A is equal to A plus 1, go to start. Next what happens, printf D, that's all. Now listen carefully. First, initially, what is the value of A? 1. And print of A. So, what is printed? A is printed. Next, start. Start is some label. I don't really mind. Next, what is printed? B. 1 less than or equal to 3. True or false? True. So, what is printed? C. A is equal to A plus 1. A value is 2. Go to start. Where is start? Here. So, from this, what is the conclusion? Label is not fixed as last. Label can be anything. Understand? Start after, again you need to come down, right? So what is printed? B. 2 less than or equal to 3? True. Again you print what? C. A value 2. 2 plus 1, 3. Update to A. Go to start. Print what? B. 3 less than or equal to 3? True. Print again what? C. A value is what? 4. Go to start. Print what? B. Next, 4 less than or equal to 3? False. So print what? D. Have you noticed CB is printed how many times? 3 times. But there is no loop at all, right? Who is making you to go back? Go to. If label is above, go to is below, this is called backward jump. This is called what? Backward jump. If label is above, if go to is above, label is below, this is called forward jump. This is called what? Forward jump. So totally we are having two type of jumps. One is a forward jump, another is a backward jump. What is forward jump? Go to is above, label is below. What is backward jump? Label is above, go to is below, right? Next, I'll try to solve one small example. Okay. Yes. So one question in the interview room is, you need to print 1 to 100 without using any loop. Loop you should not use to print 1 to 100. How do you do that? Initially, I'll take A is equal to 1, okay? Next, what will I do? If A less than or equal, okay, I need to have a label, right? I'll take a label called L1. Any name you can take, we don't have any issues. If A less than or equal to 100, what I'll do? Printf percentile D, comma A. Next, what will I do? A is equal to A plus 1, go to L1. That's all, completed. Now, see, initially, what is the value of A? 1, L1, 1 less than or equal to 100, 2, 1 is printed, A value will be 2, go to L1, 2 less than or equal to 100, true. Let us take currently the value of A is 99. 99 less than or equal to 100, true. Means print what? 99. 99 plus 1, 100. Go to L1, A value is 100. 100 less than or equal to 100 is also true. Print what? 100. 100 plus 1, 101. A value is 101. Go to L1, 101 less than or equal to 100 is false. So what is the intention of this program? We are printing 1 to 100 without using any loops. Well, so we have written some examples here. I recommend you people to see all the examples still there. And what you can do is pause the video, try to guess the output. Total we have how many examples? 10 examples, right? So all the 10 examples you better write it and solve it. Anyway, I am going to provide the solution, but our interest is we should not do it, you should only do, because you are appearing for the placement, not we. We want you to do more practice, correct? Well, first example, what is printed? A, go to end, but there is no end, right? That is the reason we are going to get compilation error. What is the compilation error we are getting is undefined label end. Undefined label end. So from this, what is important point? Whenever there is a go to statement, compulsory we should have label. See, whenever you are writing else, we need if. Whenever we are writing do, we need while. Like that, if you have go to, label is compulsory. Now second example, first A is printed, start. Start means we really don't know where is go to. So what is output? A and B. So from the second example, what is the conclusion? If there is a label, if there is a label, go to is optional, correct? If there is a go to, label is compulsory. If is there, else optional. Else is there, if compulsory. While is there, do optional. Do is there, while compulsory, like that. Go to is there, label compulsory. Label is there, go to optional. Remember that. Next, A. Go to here, directly I came, nothing to do, right? And I printed what? B. So what is the conclusion of this example? If there is no statement between go to and label, nothing will happen. That is the conclusion. Next, what is printed? A, go to sum. Sum is here, I'll come here. Understand, after the label, not required to have any statement. Not required to have any statement. Next, what we have? A, go to 375, I will come to 375 and I will print C. That's how we are thinking. No. Answer is compilation error, expression syntax. Why? Because a label name should start with alphabet or underscore. A label name should start with what? Alphabet or underscore. But we are starting with 3, right? 3 is a number. Okay. Next, this program. Have you noticed? Go to statement should end with what? Semicolon. But label should end with what? Colon. But here opposite, right? Go to should end with a semicolon, label should end with a colon. That is the reason you are getting compilation error expression syntax. Go to should end with what? Semicolon. Label should end with what? Colon. That's what. Very important. Now this is interesting. Can I write one go to within another go to? Yes, absolutely no problem. First, what is printed? A is printed. Go to here means I'll come here. Next, what is printed? D is printed. Go to start here. I'll print here C. Next, D. Next, again, go to start. C, D. C, D. Goes on infinite. Okay. That's what it is. Next. This is little important. Listen. So, in interview room, there are some kind of people. What they are trying to do is, they are asking, can you write a code to execute both if body and else body? Yes. This is a proof that I can execute if body and else body. Try to understand. First, what is printed? A is printed. 3 greater than 2, true or false? True. What is printed? B is printed. Go to there. Where is there? Here. Oh, I did not write there. Let us assume here there is there. Okay. So from here, I should come to there. And what is printed? D, E, F. Sequential. So, whenever go to is asking you to go somewhere, you can go happily. There is no restriction. By seeing this, what is the important thing you notice? Go to is behaving little dangerously, right? So the most rarely used keyword in C language is go to. Very rarely we use go to keyword, not frequently we use, because this type of dangerous behavior we are going to get. Now int A. Initially, what will be the value of A? Garbage value. Go to inside. Directly I am coming inside, right? I never executed initialization and condition. Without initialization and condition, coming into the loop is meaningless, correct? So who is making you to do that go to? That is the reason go to is a very dangerous keyword. You should use very carefully. So what is printed? garbage value. End of the loop, a is equal to a plus 1 will be what? Next garbage value. Next garbage value less than or equal to 5, we really don't know. God also don't know, right? So garbage value, if it is less, print it. Till loop falls. Till loop fails. So that's what very important point. So what is the conclusion in these two programs? If is executed, else is also executed, which is a stupid activity. Without checking the loop, we are coming inside. That is also stupid activity. Who is making you these possibilities? Go to. From this, it is very important point that go to is very dangerous. We should use carefully, and it is rarely used also, right? And 10th program, very important. A is printed, go to here. From here, you need to come to here. Understand. Go to will take the control from one place to another place within the same function. Go to cannot take the control from one function to another function. Go to cannot take the control from one function to another function. That is the reason what answer you are getting? Compilation error. Listen carefully now. We are getting compilation error. What is the compilation error we are getting is undefined label here. Because whenever you are writing go to here in the main function, compiler is always looking for the main function only. Now, very important point I am discussing here carefully. Listen. So, in which scenario I can use go to? Listen carefully. While condition. Right? Now you are here. My entire functionality is completed. I want to come out of the three loops at a time. Understand? I am here. My entire functionality is completed. I want to come out of the three loops at a time. If you use break here, always we are coming with the nearest loop. Means you will come here only. But I want to come out of the three loops, right? Simply what can I write here? Go to. I can write some meaningful name outside. And I can put here what? Outside. So, listen carefully. Sorry, label, no? Listen carefully. Whenever we fall deep into nested loops, and if you want to come out of all the nested loops, you need to use what? Go to. Very rarely keyword is go to in C language.